Corporate, but I won't fill in the terms. political term. But here's the head, and then other places they have their a-hole. Anyway, they're spewing out all kinds of dirty pollution. So again, welcome to 345 California, one of the corporate offices of Chevron up on the 18th floor. And we want them to hear what we think about what they can do to our environment. And I'd like to introduce another person who really knows what's going on out in Richmond and in Chevron corporate headquarters, and that's Mr. Andres Soto. A wonderful organization called Communities for a Better Environment. So, please.
Good morning, everybody. How y'all doing? Thank you for being out here and standing up to the power that's trying to destroy our planet. I grew up in Richmond, spent my whole life in Richmond, raised my family in Richmond, and have seen the damage, not just environmentally, that Chevron has done to our community, but their efforts to destroy our community itself, pitting people against each other, selective funding of nonprofits, trying to buy our elections, and trying to defeat clean air rules. So we know what they're up to. We know that it's all about the greed of trying to pay off their shareholders, the people who invest in destroying this planet. And our job as a community, it's our job as the people, it's our job as a movement to destroy their economy. So how do we destroy that economy? We have to interrupt it at every possible place we can. That means interrupting it in the politics. That means blocking boats going up to the Arctic. That means interrupting the bomb trains they want to send to our communities, putting our communities at risk to bring in the extreme crude from Canada and North Dakota. It means all these things and many more. We are creative people. We are the ones who have put these beautiful signs together and are bringing it in the streets and right to the doorstep of the evil empire. So thank you for being here this morning. You're beautiful.
Mr. Dad, we got it. Mr. People, we got it. Extinction. maybe behind the van. Perfect. Thank you.
We're going to go to the head. Yeah.
I get the rhythm right. Let's try it one more. We're gonna stop. Stop. Body Barry. Fucking up. Let's talk to Paris. We're gonna stop. Stop. Body Barry. Fucking up. Let's talk to Paris. Gonna stop. Stop. Body Barry. Fucking up. Let's talk to Paris. Stop. Stop. Body Barry. Fucking up. Let's talk to Paris.
I'm not getting to the video.
I did, and it doesn't go.
dark night when the U.S. is heating right, but then we can get better. We got purpose rights in the air and the Congress has to put one job to bear. It's fine, banger. Now I catch feelings. You don't even care about the debt ceiling. The only thing that our Congress is doing is working to bring women's rights to ruin. We don't need some jobs, not cuts. We're not punks. America's got fucks. And we should spend that on infrastructure and classes of identity, rich people taxes, and give back to the people hurting. And he's right now, he wants to be certain. First man is down. The what?
Man
is down. The what?
Man is down.
The what? Man
is down. The what?
Man is down. It's time to march.
Time to march.
Say it now. To march.
Time to march.
Time to march.
Time to march.
Come on, work for y'all. We need green jobs, education, single payers, yeah. No waiting. Every American should be able to make a living. Have faith in the same thing for their children. I see Congress now with cash flow. We need to end war. Invest in home. We want to eat at the table and eat the stage so we can give our teachers an increasing wage. And the wealthy get very little cash so we can begin to bring back the middle class and make this country great. That's no accident. We can bring it back to the spirit of Adam. And the people of America's backbone. And that's the truth, even if it's still a rhyme song. It's not long till the times ahead. It's a long way to go to the promised land. It's no time to what?
Time to
what? Time to
what?
Time to what?
Time to
what?
Time to what?
I hope so, because then you said that you made it up for something.
One more time.
Let's give it up.
Free jobs, not jails. Parks, not prisons. We won't stop till everybody listens. Free jobs, not jails. Parks, not prisons. We won't stop till everybody listens. Free jobs, not jails. Parks, not prisons. We won't stop till everybody listens. Green jobs, not jails. Parks, not prisons. We won't stop till everybody listens. Green jobs, not jails. Parks, not prisons. We won't stop till everybody listens. Green jobs, not jails. Parks, not prisons. We won't stop till everybody listens.
Anyone know what else they fund a massive amount of?
Coal
and oil on the North Sea of Britain, in the coal fields of Germany, where the biggest fund is the fossil fuel industry in Europe. It's ridiculous. The fossil fuel industry are the most that is sponsoring the talks on how to regulate themselves. And that's why we're out in the streets taking direct action in this continent, in Australia, where people have launched Move on Australia a couple of weeks ago, with climate justice action over in Europe, with the Pan-African Movement for Climate Justice, which is launching action against across Africa in the run-up to the talks. There's a global movement because we realize the folks up in Paris, the world leaders, are not actually interested in addressing the root causes of our problem: colonialism, capitalism, white supremacy, patriarchy, systems of domination, at least our crisis, and the others, but are interested in preserving the status quo in the midst of a growing crisis. Yes. Capitalism, and that's what Paris is actually about. So we have to win this fight here in the streets. Yeah. So I got a little song that actually learned in San Francisco. Old Union song, and not old, the new Union song. So we rewrote the words to a little bit. And I really like it because it's what's happening here. I'm losing my voice. this a little bit, so you really have to help me with it. I want you to line by line.